class 6. This is the continuation part of your previous class. In this class, I am going to start from the page number 21, the last paragraph of page number 21. And this is the chapter number 3. And the name of the chapter is Eliza Runs Away. In the previous video, I have completed up to page number 21, but the last paragraph was left. Okay, so we are going to start from that paragraph only. Before starting the class, I would like to just give a very short recapitulation about the first part of the chapter number 3. So we have learned that Mrs. Shelby was signing the papers because he had the trade, he had the business with Mr. Haley, and he was ready to give away Mr. Tom, that means Uncle Tom, okay, who was the best slave of Mr. Shelby. On the other hand, we also saw that Mrs. Shelby, who was she was unaware of everything, okay. She did not know anything about her husband had the problems and everything, and his husband was going to sell off Uncle Tom and Harry also. So she did not know anything, okay. For the first time, she came to know that her husband was about to sell Uncle Tom. Okay, so I am starting from the page 21, the last paragraph. What? Our Tom, our good faithful Tom, who has been with us since he was a boy. You have promised him his freedom, and we have talked to him about his many a times. So Mrs. Shelby was shocked, and she told that, what are you telling? That it's not possible for them, because it's about Uncle Tom, who was the perfect man, who was the perfect slave of Mr. Shelby. Okay, and Mrs. Shelby told that he was Uncle Tom was staying with them when Uncle Tom was a boy. Okay, and as Uncle Tom was having a very good heart, and he was always behaving properly, so they both of them, that means Mr. and Mrs. Shelby, decided that they would give him the freedom. Okay, that means Mr. Uncle Tom would not stay as a slave anymore, and they have talked in this regard many a time. Mrs. Shelby was shocked. If you can think of selling Tom, then I can believe that you can sell our little Harry too. So Mrs. Shelby told that if you think that you can sell Tom, so obviously you can think that you can sell the little boy Harry also. Okay. Mr. Shelby had been feeling guilty throughout the evening, as such his wife's word made him angry. So Mr. Shelby was very, very disturbed throughout the evening, and his words of his wife, that means what Mrs. Shelby told to Mr. Shelby, for that Mr. Shelby was very, very annoyed and very, very, what to say, that he was angry also, okay, because he knew that what he was doing, it was not wrong, it was not good, and it was totally opposite of his nature. Okay, Mr. Shelby was a perfect man, was a good man, good by his heart, good at heart. So, but he had to do these things because of his own business, for the sake of his business. So, he could not control himself. So, he was very angry also. Well, since you must know, I have agreed to sell both Tom and Harry. I do not know why I should be considered a monster for doing something that everyone does every day, said Mrs. Shelby with impatience. So Mr. Shelby was very impatient, and he could not control himself. He lost his control, and he told that told his wife that if you have heard that I am going to sell Tom along with the little Harry, so yes, it is true, I am going to sell them. So why you are thinking that I am a monster? Who was saying this? It was said by Mr. Shelby. Shelby told that why he was regarded as a monster. Because everyone who was, that means white people, they had the power to sell the Negro people. Okay, so everyone was doing that and every day. So why only he was, regarded as the monster. He was regarded as, unkind person. Okay, Mrs. Shelby was distressed. Do you have to sell them? Can't we sell something else? I'm ready to face any inconvenience. So what is the meaning of this? That means Mrs. Shelby was telling that why are you selling them? You can sell anything else, anything which that means not these slaves. You can sell anything else. Whatever you will do, I will face the consequences. Who was saying this? Mrs. Shelby was saying that as her husband's business was not running properly, so she can make her mind, she can face the consequence. She did not allow her husband to sell their slaves. Okay, I'm ready to, I have cared for them, instructed them and shared all their joys and sorrows. I have taught them the duties of a family, of parent and child, husband and wife. How can I show them otherwise that we have no feelings or duty towards them? So Mrs. Shelby was telling that we are just like their parents. We are just like their gods. Okay. So we, from the childhood, we gave them, we nurtured them, we gave them, moral, that means morality. We gave them promise that how they will behave. And what are the duties of a slave, what are the duties of a parent, what is the duties of a husband, wife. Okay, so she was telling that Mr. and Mrs. Shelby, both of them, they were like their parents. Okay, they were treating them always like that. So now how can they sell them, how can they tell that they are going to sell? Okay, so it was not possible for Mrs. Shelby. Okay, now how can I show them otherwise that we have no feelings or duty towards them? Now Mrs. Shelby told that how can I say them that we don't have any feelings, we don't have any love, we don't have any respect towards them? Okay, I have always told them that one soul is worth more than all the money in the world. So Mrs. Shelby told that she always told that one good soul is enough than the money of the world. Okay, that means the first you have to be a good person, you have to make a good heart, and money is comes in secondary, money comes as secondary. Okay, primary, that means the first thing is that you have to make yourself a very good person. Okay, so how can she would tell them that they are going to sell, their own slaves for the money? Okay, how will I hold my head among them if we sell them for money? So the same thing she was saying, that how she would say that they are sold, because Uncle Tom and Harry were sold because of the money, because she only told to them that money comes second, first the good soul. So and now they are only, that means Mrs. Shelby told to Mr. Shelby that they are only saying that money comes first, so they are selling their good slaves. Okay, So now, I'm really sorry that you feel like this, but I have no choice. Either I sell them or lose everything. So Mr. Shelby, that he was very sorry that Mrs. Shelby was thinking like that, but he could not do anything, because if he would not sell anyone, so he had to lose everything, whatever Mr. Shelby had. Haley has come into possession of a mortgage. I have scrapped and borrowed and can just manage to make up the balance with the price of this tool. Haley has taken a fancy to the child. So Mr. Shelby told that Mr. Haley took all the properties and everything, and because I borrowed the money from him, so now it is the time to return. If I don't return the money, so what would happen? So they would take everything from me. So they had to, that means Haley wanted, that means Uncle Tom, not only Uncle Tom, he also wanted little Harry. So that is why Mr. Shelby was going to give away, that means was going to give them. Okay. Now, Haley has taken a fancy to the child. And also, Mr. Shelby informed to his wife that Mr. Haley, who was a trader, he liked Harry also. Okay. I have to do this as I am in his power and he will come for them in the morning. You are feeling bad enough for selling this too. How would you feel if I had to sell all of them? So Mr. Shelby told that now you are feeling bad. Mr. Shelby told to his wife that you are feeling bad for these two people. So what will happen when if I don't give them all, and if in return if I had to give all of my slaves, so what will happen to you? So better we are going to give Uncle Tom as well little Harry.